We found a second Sony Indextron FP-62, this time to tear down. It's in very good working condition, so let's see what's inside. This model was introduced in 1987 and the FP-60 added a Betamax video recorder. In the video you can see the pulsing glow from one of the two photodiode window on the side of the bell. Across the screen, there are an array of triplets. One triplet consists of a red, green, blue and index stripes. The low persistence index phosphor stripe collects light from the single electron gun and combined with the photodiodes, index the single electron beam to the proper phosphor stripe. The spot size of the beam is tightly regulated to land on the proper stripes. There is no aperture grill or shadow mask as in a conventional cathode ray tube. The black circular aperture within the red glass device is the BIOS control. The BIOS adjusts the amount of electron energy the index stripes see or read. The Indextron tube is 5.25 inches diagonal measurement. Because there is no shadow mask to block the electron energy, the tube produces an extremely bright image and the typical free tube design from this era is not required. No convergence requirements and reduced parts allow Sony to build a compact handheld video projection system. The built-in television receiver and audio video inputs together with the Betamax VTR allowed plug-and-play operation. The system also included a supplied microphone for narration during business presentations. I have included a few screenshots at the end of the video to show the quality. The programs must be watched in total darkness. But other than that restriction, the Sony Indextron produced color images on par with more expensive three-tube designs of that time. The images projected on our 120-inch screen are about 100 inches in size.